Why is negative times negative equal to positive? Let's answer this question in five levels, ranging from intuitive examples to a proof that is often only seen by math majors. For level one, say we have a video of someone running forward. For this particular clip, forward is to the right, so we'll call right the positive direction and left will be negative. When we play the clip, the person runs in the positive direction. If we play the clip in reverse, the person appears to run backward in the negative direction. Symbolically, running forward is positive, and playing the clip in reverse is multiplying by a negative playback rate. So positive times negative is negative. Now consider if the original clip shows someone running backward. When we play the clip, the person runs backward, which is negative. But what happens when we play that clip in reverse? Now the person appears to be moving forward in the positive direction. In symbols, negative movement times a negative playback speed equals positive movement. For level two, let's consider another intuitive argument. If your friend gives you three $5 bills, that's positive three times positive five, which is positive $15 for you. If your friend instead gives you three of their debts of $5 each, that's positive three times negative five, which means you've lost $15. So positive three times negative five is negative 15. But now what happens if your friend takes away three of your debts of $5 each? That's negative three times negative five, which is positive because your debts have been removed. So negative three times negative five is positive 15. Again, we have an intuitive argument for why negative times negative is positive. For level three, let's look at the number line. When we multiply 2 times 3, this is repeated addition, 2 plus 2 plus 2. We move 2 units to the right on the number line 3 times, and we end up at 6. If we multiply negative 2 times 3, we move 2 units to the left 3 times, ending at negative 6. We see the effect of the negative sign is to reflect the result about 0, causing the number line to flip. So what happens when we multiply negative 2 times negative 3? Now the two negatives have reflected that number twice so that we end up back in the original position and the answer is going to be positive 6. In other words, we've subtracted negative 2 three times, which is moving to the right on the number line and ends at positive 6. For level 4, let's take a step toward a proof. We'll make this argument fully rigorous in the next level. Let's show that negative 2 times negative 3 is equal to positive 6. So start with negative 2 times negative 3, and then let's add 2 times 0, which is just adding 0, so it's not going to change the value. Then let's write 0 as negative 3 plus positive 3. Next, let's multiply out that last term using the distributive property. We now have negative 2 times negative 3 plus 2 times negative 3 plus 2 times 3. Next, we can factor out the negative 3 from those first two terms using the distributive property again. Now we have negative 3 times negative 2 plus 2 plus 2 times 3. We're pretty close now because negative 2 plus positive 2 is 0, so that first term is negative 3 times 0, which is just 0. So all we really have left is 2 times 3, which we know is 6. So we've shown that negative 2 times negative 3 equals positive 6. For level 5, let's prove the law of sines. Not the triangle one, but the one from ring theory. A ring is a set with two binary operations that we call addition and multiplication that satisfy certain properties. One example of a ring is the set of integers, so as we go through these properties, if you want, you can imagine that all the values are integers. In order for the set R to be a ring with operations addition and multiplication, we want these properties to be true for all elements A, B, and C in the ring R. First, if you add or multiply two elements in the ring, the result is still in the ring. Next, addition is commutative and associative, so we can add elements in any order we like. There is an additive identity, which we'll call zero. This means A plus zero equals A for every A, or in other words, adding zero does not change the value. Next, every element A has an additive inverse that we call negative A. This means that A plus negative A equals zero. Next, multiplication is associative. And lastly, the distributive property holds. A times B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. And the same property holds with the multiplication in the other order. Just for convenience, let's also assume that multiplication is commutative. This extra requirement gives us a special type of ring called a commutative ring. This isn't necessary, and if you want, you can make some very small tweaks to our proof to make it work for any ring. Rings can be pretty abstract at first, but there are many common examples of rings. For example, the integers, the rational numbers, the real numbers, and the complex numbers are all rings. Another example is 12-hour time. We can add or multiply two different hours on the clock. For example, 4 hours after 10 o'clock is 2 o'clock, so we can write 4 plus 10 equals 2. To multiply 5 times 3, we can start at 0, what we usually call 12 o'clock, and then we can add 5 hours 3 times. We get to 5 o'clock, 10 o'clock, and lastly 3 o'clock. So we can say 5 times 3 equals 3 in this ring. This is called the ring of integers modulo 12. There is one final fact we need, which is that a times 0 equals 0 for any a in the ring. To prove this, we can write a times 0 equals a times 0 plus 0, and then use the distributive property to split that up as a times 0 plus a times 0. Now we subtract an a times 0 from both sides to get a times 0 equals 0. So multiplying by 0 always gives us 0 in the ring. Now we're ready to prove the result. Let's start with negative a times negative b, and then add a times 0, which is just adding 0. Then we can write 0 as negative b plus b, and use the distributive property to expand this to negative a times negative b plus a times negative b plus ab. Now use the distributive property again to factor the negative b from the first two terms. We get negative b times negative a plus a plus ab. Notice negative a plus a is just 0, so that first term is just 0, and all we have left is ab. So there we have it, a rigorous proof of the law of sines for commutative rings. I'll leave this to you if you want to slightly rework the proof to get that result to hold for non-commutative rings. And in fact, you can even relax some of the other conditions slightly, and the proof will still work. Do you have another method to show that negative times negative is positive? Please let us know in the comments. I look forward to reading about them. Thanks so much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing to support the channel and for similar videos, and I'll see you next time.